Good afternoon, everyone. The topic of my e-poster presentation is Gunshot Injury with Ambiguous Manner, a case report. First of all, introduction. A firearm is any weapon which discharges a missile by the expansive force of gases produced by burning of an explosion substance. Firearm wounds are usually recognized without difficulty due to their specific findings, such as singeing, tattooing, and blackening, etc. Now, case report. The postmortem examination of a deceased male, 25 years of age and resident of a village under PS Asoda Jhajjar, was conducted in a board wide FIR number --- under section 302 IPC and 25-54-59 PS Asoda Jhajjar. The apparent cause of death as per police inquest report was Goli Lagne Se. As per PI from CMO PGIMS Rohtak, the patient came brought dead in the accident and emergency department of PGIMS Rohtak at 11:16 PM on dated 21st Jan 2021 with alleged history of gunshot at Jhajjar at 10:30 PM on 29th Jan 2021. The body was wearing a blue and yellow colored full sleeved check shirt. Both the sleeves of the shirt were folded up to the level of both elbow joint. An irregular defect was present over the left side of anterior aspect of shirt and edges of the defect were hardened and blackened. Another small circular defect was present over the posterior aspect of left side of shirt and fibers of the defect were protruding out. Shirt was stained with blood at places. A gray colored jeans with hooks and zipper at front, closed in situ and stained with blood at places. A blue colored kachcha with elastic at waistline. Now the injuries. First of all, an entry wound of firearm in form of circular defect of diameter 1.5 cm was present over the anterior aspect of left side of lower chest wall situated 6.5 cm left to midline and 125 cm above the left heel. It was surrounded by muzzle impression at the periphery wall over 0.6 cm away from the edge of the main defect. Abrasion collar was present all over it and the fine tattooing was over the inferior lateral aspect of the defect suggestive of loose contact shot. On dissection of thoracic cavity, the track of the wound was going posteriorly, slightly medially and downwards, piercing the underlying structure such as fifth intercostal space of the left side of chest along with pleura. Lower border of left rib and upper border of sixth rib was raised anterior aspect of pericardium, tearing and left ventricle of the heart is stellate fashion. Pleura and left lung over its hilar region at the junction of both lobes. Left pleural cavity contained about 2500 cc of liquid blood admixed with clotted blood. Left lung was found collapsed and shrunken, occupying only 2/3 of space of left hemothorax. Cherry red discoloration was present throughout the track. On exploration, the track was going through and through the left side of the posterior thoracic wall, piercing the ninth intercostal space and seen as exit wound in the form of circular defect of diameter 1 cm, which was situated 4 cm left to midline and 121 cm above the left heel. The margins of the wound was punched out with evisceration of the fat tissue from the underlying layers of the skin. When correlated with the wound with the defect over the clothing, it was found the position were almost at the same level. On internal examination, all the organs were pale and viscera was reserved for chemical analysis. Now, cause of death in this case. After conduction of autopsy, the cause of death was to be opined as hemorrhagic shock and its complication consequent to the injury to thoracic viscera as a result of firearm and hand swab is preserved for GSR. After perusal of autopsy report, GSR report, crime scene report along with photographs and thorough investigation report of the police, it was opined by the board that the manner of infliction of injuries were suicidal in manner. Now discussion. In this present case, the police designated it as homicide under section 302 of the Indian Penal Code. But after considering all the reports, circumstances, photographs and meticulous examination of dead body excluded the possibility of the injury could be inflicted by someone else and completely denied the theory of police of homicide. Though single entry wound of the firearm could be reason of ambiguity in context of manner, but scrupulous investigation and scrutiny of all the possibilities could result in reliable conclusion and so concrete opinion regarding the manner of death. Thank you.